I got over 36,000 views. Oh, I am getting so emotional from talking about this. How's everyone doing today? It's Susan and welcome back to a new video. Today is the first time I'll be sharing a story time with you guys, so sit back and relax. This will be a story of why I deleted a viral TikTok video. Just a heads up, this story will be really sad. If you don't want to hear sad and upsetting things, then this video probably isn't for you. But if you want to hear my experiences with TikTok, then keep on watching. My channel is based around positivity and happiness. And if you know me, I'm all about positivity. But I also really want to showcase my real life, and I can't always be happy. There are some days that I feel really sad and upset. But I always have a little voice in my head telling me that everything will be okay, and to always keep going. I feel that it's really important to tell this story because it may be helpful if you or anyone you know have experienced any kind of negative comments or hate. Especially on social media, to know that you are not alone and to always keep going and do the things you're passionate about. To start off the story, let's go back in time to where I decided to make a TikTok account and to start making videos. Just like YouTube, I wanted to try this for a very long time, but I didn't have the courage to start. I believe I started TikTok in May, soon after my YouTube channel was created. I wanted to try TikTok because it was the latest trend and so many people were doing it. I also really wanted to promote my YouTube channel. I thought I would try it out and see how it goes. And I was really hesitant to start. Before I started making the TikTok videos, I scrolled through many videos and thought it was so funny. I really wanted to entertain people too, and I tried recreating the TikToks that other people were making. It was really fun, so I learned some of the dances and uploaded the videos. At first, I got like 10 to 20 views, and then I got more views later on. I was really happy with it, and I loved the songs. It had become my hobby. Before my viral video, I think the most views I have ever gotten was around 400. But then I made a video with Simba, who is my yellow lab. That skyrocketed to over 36,000 views. I was very surprised at this, and I didn't know how I got that many views, as I only had 20 followers. I guess any video can become viral. I was so excited about this, but then the comments started coming. I would say about 98% of the comments were really negative and really hurtful. People were wondering what was the lump under his neck. I can't blame people for wondering, but the comments were really hurtful and made me so upset. And before I talk more about this, here is the video that became viral. I just took a DNA test, turns out I'm 100%. A good boy. People were assuming that I don't take him to the vet and I should take him now and use really forceful language. Simba does go to the vet, and if you saw my last video, we just took Simba to the vet to get his lump checked and to get some shots. Some people were saying that he has a tumor, he probably has cancer, and that he is going to die soon. These were the most hurtful comments that I have ever received. This video was posted at the beginning of June, and I am now just opening up about it. Simba is so special to me, and to hear people say these things really broke my heart. Simba is my best friend, and he has helped me overcome so many obstacles. In social media, this was the first time that I have received any kind of hate or negative comments, so I really didn't know how to react. This made me so sad to hear people say these things. I got over 80 comments, and they were mostly all about Simba's lump. I have replied to a lot of these comments explaining what the lump is, and I even made a video talking about what Simba's lump is. And still, people kept asking, which was so frustrating. Simba's lump is benign, which is harmless. It's just the fatty lump, which is common for yellow labs. The comments at first were just assumptions, but then the comments were getting more intense. And people were saying that he's going to die soon. And I drew the line at this. I have thought long and hard about deleting this video, but then I finally deleted the video when people were telling me things like this. And I almost started crying because I couldn't take it anymore. When Simba went to the vet 2 weeks ago, the vet still thinks the lump is really harmless and nothing to worry about, but we are going to double check it. We have decided to get Simba's lump removed as I think he is feeling uncomfortable. And at the same time, we are going to have his teeth cleaned. After they remove Simba's lump, they will do a biopsy to make sure that it's still nothing to worry about. In the TikTok video, people were just focusing on Simba's lump instead of how cute and sweet he is. Even though I could've just disabled the comments, I just decided to delete the whole video because I don't want to see the comments anymore. And I also don't want others to read the comments as it could enable you to be in a bad mood. As these comments were really extreme. I guess this is the risk of social media, of having negative comments and a new video can become viral. I'm still waiting for one of my YouTube videos to blow up. Okay, that was a little dramatic, but I really want one of my YouTube videos to go viral. I don't know when that's going to be, but with every video, the chance increases. And I am prepared for any type of negative comments or hate that I receive. So if you would like to help me out, be sure to share this video with everyone you know. Since I have been on social media a lot now and are becoming public, I have learned that there are lots of negative people out there who want to bring you down. But it's so important to not let that get to you and to always keep going and doing the things you love. Even though this is the risk of social media, I still really want to showcase my life and be a public figure. A few weeks later, I did an experiment and reposted the same video that went viral, and can you guess how many views it got? It literally got 5 views. Thank you so much for listening to my story, and if you liked the story today, please be sure to give it a thumbs up, comment, and subscribe. Thank you so much to everyone who has supported me and got me to 200 subs. This means so much to me, and I'm thinking that if I get to 1,000 subs, I'll do a giveaway. So now my new goal is to reach 300 subs by the end of August. Do you guys think we can do it? Thank you everyone for watching, and see you in the next video.